Hi, my name is Brock Berman with Andreani USA. Today we're going to teach you how to set up your SAG properly, or at least the way we do it. This is a 2022 GasGas MC450, barely ridden vet rider. Stay tuned for details. I'd like to introduce Pietro.
Ciao everyone.
Today he's going to show us how we set the SAG on our dirt bike here. So Pietro, why do we need to set the SAG?
Okay, the SAG is the first thing. So when you buy the bike, or you have a new bike, or you change the spring, you need to check if that spring is good for your weight.
Okay.
And the free SAG is the first measurement that you're gonna make, and then you're gonna make a rider SAG.
Okay.
The balance between the two sides gonna say if the spring is right for your weight.
Okay, awesome, sounds pretty important.
Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna show you my way, how I do the SAG.
Awesome.
Cool.
Okay, Brock, I'm gonna show you my way. I'm gonna take in the middle the axle of a swing arm, in the middle of axle of the rear wheel, and just I turn the tape measurement, and I'm gonna make a mark. You're gonna make a mark.
Right.
Okay, and now we're gonna show why I do like this. Please help me, because the wheel working like that. And no vertical, but in that way.
So Pietro, for the first measurement, we do it on the stand, the bike on the stand?
Yes, it's very important. The wheel need to stay out from the floor. And then from our mark, I take in the axle in the middle, 55 centimeter of iron. Well, perfect. Now we go in the front and we're gonna make the same. Okay, in the front, just you can take it from the clamp to the border of the axle clamp is 86. Okay, now we're gonna check the static.
Okay.
Just pushing a couple times the suspension. You can hold it. And we could take again from our mark in the middle the real axle.
52.
We go in the front, we're gonna make it the same. From the clamp, 66 and one.
Okay.
Okay, now we're gonna make the rider SAG.
Okay.
And normally with the full gear, with the helmet, and we need to check with your weight.
Okay.
Now you go on the bike, Luciano, please, can I help you?
Yep.
Okay, your normal position, just push a couple times on the bike, okay, and sit. We take from our mark, in the middle of the axle, 65.
Okay.
Okay. After we're gonna make in the front. And now we're gonna check also the forks.
Okay.
Okay. Back in the bike, Luciano, please. I need your help. Push a couple times. Okay, and your normally position, riding position. And we're gonna have a 645.
Okay.
Thank you.
So Pietro, how do these numbers look? Can you do the math and show me where I'm at and if my spring rate is right?
Yes, in the front, just we can check the spring rate, we can modify the free SAG without open the forks, of course.
Yeah.
And we check from the first to the second, we're gonna have the free SAG, the static. And you have 25 millimeter free sag. Okay. It's okay.
Yep.
But these need to match with the rider sag.
Right, when I'm on it.
Bravissimo. And you have a 41 and you are in the range.
Okay. What is that range supposed to be, in your opinion?
Minimum 20 mm-hmm. free sag, yep. maximum 30
okay.
free sag.
Okay.
And minimum 35 to 55.
Okay, so we're pretty close there.
Yeah. Now, for the shock, is different things, because we can modify the preload, but we check what we have right now. Right now, we have 30 millimeter free sag.
Okay.
It's not good.
Okay.
And the rider sag is 85.
Okay. That was when I was sitting on the bike, right?
Exactly.
And this was from the bike on the stand to sitting
the bike,
by
the
itself.
Bike alone.
Okay.
Exactly. And normally here depends on the racetrack, the dirt, the...
Yeah.
Here we go 35 to 40. And here to 95 to 05.
Okay.
For that, we need to modify this.
Okay.
Too much preload, we need to take preload from the shock.
Okay.
Okay, in this case, we are lucky because the Broc has a mechanic preload. It's very easy to do, but with another shock like this, you're gonna lose the first and use the spanner or the hand to adjust the spring.
Sounds bad.
Okay, now we double check the free sag. Okay. Just take the stand on the bike, please. We're gonna push it a couple times. And from our mark, 510, we are 40 millimeter free sag.
Okay.
Please, back in the bike and Luciano,
yeah.
Can you help me? Okay, push a couple times. Perfetto, 450. There we go. Now, Broc, you are ready to go to the racetrack and wide open.
Dominate.
Okay, Broc, now I write down what we have, and we have a 40 free sag and 100 right sag.
Okay, awesome. But is that good for like all terrains, or should that change?
No, gonna change. That is good for you because you can use the free sag for more traction or more stability.
Okay.
Traction, if you have hard pack, you can go to 42, 44. You're gonna have a more traction.
Okay.
The shock working more and then start working hydraulic and spring. But if you have a sand, you go up to 35.
Okay, so you want the bike more up and on top of the sand versus
exactly.
sitting in the sand.
Also in the mud, because the bike is gonna be more heavy,
okay.
and you're gonna have a more support from the spring.
Okay, awesome. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. It was fun making it. I learned a lot, I hope you guys did too. If there's any other videos you wanna learn about, put it in the comments and then like and subscribe and we'll get to those.
Ciao Ciccio, see you soon for another tips.